Hey, what's up, guys? Tony here, and even though I think I said a long time ago that I wasn't going to do like a video vlog kind of a thing, here I am doing a video vlog kind of thing. So, anyways, I'm back over where I used to live here in Vista. I was going to do an oil change, and then I wanted to talk about my exhaust story because it's an interesting one, nevertheless. And I usually like this road. Just push it on a Sunday, no one's around. So, anyways, I was gonna do an oil change, and I found out very, very quickly that the jacks that my grandfather has that I have, they don't fit. They won't fit underneath my car. They're too thick. They're really sturdy jacks. I mean, these are like 2-ton jacks. So anyways, can't get the oil change done. And I only have 3,600 miles. And I was looking through the book because my older brother was over here as well. And he took off and he's just like, why are you doing an oil change right now? And I said, well, it's been over 3,000 miles. I mean, like, it's the old adage, you know, 3 months, 3,000 miles to do an oil change. And so he's like, yeah, it should be longer than that. So I checked the Ford manual, as I guess any good car owner should. And so with sort of everyday driving, this car should have an oil change every like 7,000 to 10,000 miles, which boggles my mind because I'm like, that's a long time. Usually it's 3,000 miles, 3 months, 3,000 miles. And then so with like moderate use, kind of aggressive, it's like 5,000 to 7,000. And with like extreme use, like heavy towing, and that's what it says in the book, heavy towing, things like that, it's every 3,000 to 5,000 miles. So I'm like, I'm kind of in the middle, you know. I daily drive this thing. I drive it hard every now and again. So I'm probably more in the, I could probably get away with 5,000 to 6,000 miles. Now, the one thing that I actually wanted to do, which probably not a good idea right now, is there was one that says oil life, I believe it is. Yeah, I'm not going to be able to mess with it right now. It'll say my oil life. My oil life like a month ago was like 79%. And so I was like, well, it's probably down below that now. Oh, I wanted to go that way. Shit. All right. Well, anyways. Needless to say, I've 3,624 miles. I've got time to spare. I did buy oil and filter, and I was going to go down to a shop and do the oil change, have them do the oil change, charge like $35. Oil itself was like $45. So I'd much rather just wait the extra couple thousand, have the oil in stock. My brother's like, go get those ramps, man. I got those ramps. I'm driving my Mustang on it and they can work on my car. I said, you know what? I might just do that. Go buy those ramps and, do the oil changes that way. So, leads me to the exhaust. I picked up, like showed that little clip. Picked up a Cobb exhaust middle of December. Quite a generous Christmas it was for myself. And the Cobb exhaust was $800. And it had been one that I was looking at for a very long time because it's stainless steel and it looks amazing. And I've heard that it sounds amazing. So anyways, I was like, yeah, I really, really want this exhaust. Cause the other one was the MBRP, I think it's about $500. And well, the one thing I did not like about that exhaust was the simple fact that, it has these tips. They have, their little clamps on them. I'm like, God, that seems so cheap. Like, these are like stainless steel. They're all welded, beautiful. And I just, I don't, but fuck it, I liked it. It was expensive, and you know, I'm like, I'm gonna pay for quality because that's what I want. And above all of that, it's supposed to have been the quietest exhaust on the market. And so I said, you know what? I like that. I want a quiet exhaust. Simply because my girlfriend Mel, who maybe I can see if she wants to make an appearance in this video, she's not really into all this stuff. And so I'm trying to be considerate with my mods. And so anyways, I'm trying to be considerate to her. She doesn't like this kind of stuff. I love this kind of stuff. I've been doing this kind of stuff since I was 18 and I had my first car, a 2000 Mirage. And so for me, I like having an exhaust that I can really hear. I like that racy exhaust sound. And so she doesn't want to be obnoxious. She doesn't want to be obnoxious. And so that was the whole purpose for my purchase. And I'm finding now that the Cobb exhaust, while outside is not really that loud, the interior, the cabin noise, is far louder than I was expecting. This is actually the road that I wanted to come through to get to the 78, but I missed it. I was just like talking and totally missed it. So anyways, we're going to head back the way we came. And then we're going to go drive by Dark House, his area, because I thought that'd be kind of fun for him to see that part of Vista in a video. So anyways, what are you doing? I think she's lost. What was I saying? Oh yeah, so I made my purchase to be considerate to her, while at the same time still getting a 3-inch exhaust with a nice flow. You know, and yeah, would I like a loud, obnoxious exhaust? You know what? Honestly, I'm 32 going on 33, driving a 4-cylinder. I think I'm done with the days of being obnoxious to my neighbors as I sort of drive through this neighborhood or backcountry area. So anyways, yeah, that was one of the biggest factors. This is what I liked about it. I liked the fact that it was, you know, stainless steel, high quality Cobb exhaust. I already have Cobb products. You know, they come highly recommended for the Focus. Subaru as well, I think Mazda 3, the Speed. So they have a good name in the industry for, you know, at least for Ford that I know of. So anyways, that's why I picked that up. That's why I decided to splurge, spend a little bit more money, and I did. And I'm not unhappy. The only thing, like I said, is that for me, my expectation was that the exhaust would be a little quieter. Now, I think I'm getting used to the exhaust because it doesn't sound like it drones as much as I remember initially. And it also is more likely settling in as well, getting covered in all sorts of hydrocarbons on the inside of the exhaust. So I think that might dampen the noise just a little bit. But I'll tell you though, when I'm in like high load, like right there, there is a drone when you're under load. So what I figure I'll do is I'll get on the freeway and show like that stuff, which would have been a perfect opportunity back there, but I decided to go through this way again. To go run through the scenarios and just kind of, you know, see how loud this can record exhaust, because, I mean, it is pretty loud in the cabin. So, anyways, here's the interesting part of this entire exhaust endeavor, the whole process. Oh, actually, you need to go to Albertsons too, shit. That's my old work, by the way. I really do like the exhaust. I think it sounds amazing. So, anyways, It took several weeks to get here after I ordered it. Like I said, I think I ordered it around the 19th of December. It showed up December 30th, I think. Yeah, it was December 30th. So, New Year's Eve, I was like, I'm getting this bitch installed. Oh, is that an ST? That is an ST. Let's go. There's a black ST right in front of us. I wonder if he's on the ST forums or the Facebook page. So, anyways, I wanted to install it on the 31st. I was making some calls on the 30th about, you know, how much is it going to get cost to get installed. And so, called a couple shops. They're like, oh, it's going to be about $100 to $130, right? And I was like, oh, that's not too bad. I think that's actually pretty good. So, anyways, this is gonna wave, but he wasn't even looking. So, anyway, so $100 to $130. And so I was like, you know what? Sold. I'll do $100 to $130. I called, I don't know, this other exhaust place. I called Midas, who I eventually went to. And so what I did is I drove down New Year's Eve, probably about 9 o'clock in the morning. And the guy went in and he goes, okay, well, you know, I told you $105, $130. It really depends upon the inspection of the vehicle. So he got my car up on the rack. Depends on the vehicle. So he gets on the rack and he's just like, it's gonna be $180. I'm like, $180? Are you out of your mind? I said yesterday you said it was like $130. And what's up? He goes, well, the guy's gotta like put it up and he's gotta do all this work and we have to bill for 1.8 hours of labor. And I told him, like, 1.8 hours, it should cost you no more than like an hour at most. It's a bolt-on system. It's like, just bolt the bitch on. Needless to say, I wasn't happy, but he had up on the rack and I was like, you know, honestly, you guys, fine, you guys got to hear whatever. Let's just do it. I was pretty like, you know, I wasn't gonna cry over $50. You know, I was like, fine, whatever. Because it was New Year's Eve, I wanted to get it installed that day. And I was like, fine, whatever, I could go ahead and do it. And so I did. And so I was sitting there, the guy's like, well, it's gonna take a couple of hours. I'm like, no shit, you said you're gonna bill 1.8 hours of labor. That's what you said. So, anyways, there was a point where the manager guy was talking with another, you know, customer, and this guy has had issues. He's having a misfire, you know, P0305, misfire cylinder 5. So I hear this, the manager telling him like, oh, we got to replace the coil. We have to replace the spark plug. We need to do a full system fuel cleaning. We need to do one other thing. And it was like coming out to like $500. I'm like, what the fuck are you talking about? Whoa. I'm like, $500? That's ridiculous. So the guy goes in and it was this older dude who, oh, hold on. All right, so I don't remember what I was saying just a minute ago. So I went over to, I was at Midas, and the guy's like, oh, it's going to cost this much money. And it's going to cost this much. So he goes back, and then I go and I talk to this old guy. He's like old guy, and It's like, hey, look, I used to work as an automotive technician. You know, honestly, if it was multiple codes, multiple misfire codes, like P0300, like a multi-cylinder misfire code, but it's just P0305, so it's one cylinder, I was saying, honestly, I would just change the spark plug and go from there. And first I'd show him the spark plug so that way he could see that it's fouled or ruined or whatever. And I might even go like cylinders, since it's cylinder 5, I might go like 1, 3, and 5, so I can check all the cylinders on the same side to see like if that bank is running a certain way. And you know, show them like, hey, look, here's what's going on. And then I don't know what sort of testing they did the ignition coil rail, because it's actually one long coil with, you know, six coils on it, which I think is retarded, but whatever. So anyways, oh, got a GTR behind me, just like trying to go real fast. So anyways, that's what I was thinking. I'm like, okay, that's what I would do. I wouldn't go fuel system clean, fuel injector cleaner, you know, new plug and a new coil pack. I'm like, that's like carpet bombing the problem when you've got just one cylinder having an issue with it. So address the actual issue. And I went back and forth. I talked to this guy, and he seemed like, you know, oh, well, I'm just going to do this. This is what I'm going to do. So then Mel, my girlfriend, she came over to pick me up because it was going to be like another hour and a half, and I'd already been there for like an hour. And so we went to Pep Boys. I wanted to buy this bag that they have, like a tool bag, because all my tools are over at home or my grandma's garage, and I don't have any with me. Oh no, it's only a Z car. Never mind. So I don't have any with me at my apartment. So then we went, probably took like 20 minutes. I don't know. Got back, and the guy was still working on my car. Like, he had the exhaust on, he had my stock exhaust on the ground. He had half the exhaust put in. And so I went over and I was talking to him, and we're just bullshitting. He has a really nice V6 Accord. We're talking about that. We're talking about the exhaust. We're just, you know, just car guys talking. And so, he finishes up probably, I don't know, 15-20 minutes, finishes up, makes sure everything's tight, backs it up, gives me the keys, and I go walk in to pay. And so when I walked in to pay, the guy goes, the manager up front is like, did you get your keys? I was like, yeah. And so I got my card there, and oh, bye. It's the Nismo edition 370. So anyways, I got my card, I'm ready to pay, and the guy's just like, oh, don't worry, we took care of it. And I'm like, whoa, what a douche that guy is. He's just like, I said, what do you mean you took care of it? He goes, yeah, don't worry about it. I'm like, I said, there's like three other people in the room, and I'm like, you don't want me to pay for this? And he's like, no, we took care of it. And he's kind of being a dick about it. He like won't look at me. He's not being like nice. He's just kind of looking at his screen and just like typing away. He's like, no, we took care of it. I'm like, okay, that's weird. And then so I walked out, and then I was getting paranoid. I'm like, what the fuck's going on? So then I came back in because I'm like, I want a receipt for that. I'm not walking away without a receipt. I walked back in. I was just like, hey, can I get a receipt for that? He goes, no, man, we took care of it. Merry Christmas. He's Merry Christmas. I'm like, what the fuck? It's New Year's Eve. So anyways, he's like, Merry Christmas. And I'm like, well, I would like a receipt for the $0 invoice. He goes, no, don't worry about it. We took care of it. Merry Christmas. And now I'm getting like really paranoid. So like I walk out, I go out to the technician, and I said, hey, he didn't charge me. And the technician's like, what do you mean? I'm like, he didn't charge me for anything. Like, is that normal? Like, does he do that often? And he's just kind of like, I don't know. You know, I just put parts on cars. I don't worry about the billing stuff, basically, is the impression I got. It's a nice Beamer with a carbon fiber trunk. But anyways, that's what happened. And I left, and I was just like, well, I told the technicians, I'm like, I don't want him saying, like, I just bounced without paying. Like, what the hell? And so he's just like, I don't know. So I got in contact with a friend of mine who, he's a master technician at Volkswagen. And he said, he goes, well, did they fill out a work order? I said, no, they did not fill out a work order. And he's like, oh, that's weird. And I said, well, that, I mean, that if they were to go after you, they'd need a work order that you signed. And it was like, oh, yeah, that's right. I know that. I mean, like, when I worked as a tech, that's why we had to have a work order. And so I said, yeah, no work order. He goes, well, did they even put your parts on? Because, like, you know, they could have just screwed you. And I was like, no, I was there. I mean, like, you know, obviously it's on my car. Anyways, so, yeah, I'm like, they put it on. He goes, well, I mean, that's the bad thing. Like, the good thing is that they didn't charge you for it. But the bad thing is that if they fucked with your car, you can't go back to them and say, you fucked with my car, because there's no proof that your car was ever there. And I said, yeah, it's true. Okay. So he's like, they can't go after you. I'm like, all right, cool. Well, that's one thing I was worried about. I was like, they're going to come after me. This guy's like pissed. Because maybe the guy I talked to was like, hey, I don't think you should do this work. You know, you should do something else. You know, they're doing too much. I'm afraid that he talked to the manager and the manager's like all pissed off at me, which I don't know why he'd give me free shit. I don't know why. Anyways, I'm still kind of paranoid about it because it's weird. So anyways, long story now, really long story short, is that they installed the exhaust for free. What would have been a $180 install, the guy just waived it and they put it on for free. And so that's actually the thing I haven't done yet, is I haven't checked to see, I don't think there's any exhaust leaks. I don't feel anything. The car actually does feel like it's got a little bit more top end pickup. I'm probably, I'd have to talk to the Cobb guys. Maybe I can send them an email and ask, you know, if I can go from the stage one tune to the stage two tune. I'm not entirely sure what mods are required to make that jump, but I have their intake. I've got the exhaust, the motor mount, access port. The only thing I'm missing, I mean, if I had the front mount intercooler, I mean, that's their stage three power package. I could throw the stage three tune on and go from there. So I'm wondering, maybe I could just pop on the stage two tune and see what's up. But my goal is right now to go to the track and run a night with this setup, see what times I get. And then the next time I go to the track, I want to have, you know, something else done. So that way I can track progress. So anyways, that's kind of the dilemma I'm at right now. And I'm also looking at, I'm watching, you know, my air, charge air temps. And so the ambient temperature right now is 63 degrees. My intake temperature is 70 degrees. And my charge air temperature is 84. And if I really get on it, it's going to spike up over 100 degrees. And so a lot of the guys in the Focus ST Facebook page were saying that, you know, they get, with aftermarket intercooler, they get something like 10 degrees over ambient is what they get for charge air temps, which, you know, would be about 73 degrees. And I'm 20 degrees above right now, and I'm just driving, you know, I'm not even really running it hard. I mean, even the air intake temperature is 7 degrees over ambient. So what I've been told and what I've, you know, sort of witnessed for myself is that the stock intercooler is not very good. Let's see here. Yeah, it's already climbing over 97 degrees for charge air temperature. With that, that's that. 97 degrees. So that intercooler is not doing a good job. It's referred to as the choke point of the car. So anyways, maybe if I can talk Melanie into having this conversation, it'd be kind of nice to see, like, you know, what it is, her opinions are on the exhaust and everything. Maybe I could get her to make a cameo in this video. We'll see. But anyways, guys, appreciate you guys taking the time to watch these newer style videos that I'm doing. And so, as always, thanks for watching. Thanks for subscribing. And I shall talk to you guys later. Yeah, about time you made it.